So what is up with this laptop? It's a Core i5. Oh, and it has a NVIDIA GeForce chip in it. That's interesting because we could recompile a Ffmpeg to use the GPU to encode its video. So what's up with this thing? Let's see what happens. Oh yeah, screen is broken. That rather sucks, but we can connect the cable perhaps and you know, connect it to an external monitor, see what happens. So I think I'll just install Ubuntu on it and transform this laptop into a live stream server. So let's start with installing Ubuntu. I think I'm going to skip this part. This is rather boring actually, so I'm just going to skip ahead until I've installed it. This is my Linux desktop. I just installed Ubuntu and I installed OBS, which I'm showing now once again how I did this. It's really simple. Of course I had to install it or else this recording wouldn't be possible. That's literally all I did. So here I open up a terminal and log in as root user. Now this is something you should not do, perhaps, or, well, it's your choice. I hate having to type my password every time I type a sudo command, so I just enable the root account by making a password for it, and then log in as root, so I don't have to enter my password each time. Security-wise, this is not a smart idea, they say, but when I'm done setting up my server, I'm going to disable it again, so we're good. What am I doing here? I installed OpenSSH server so I can log in through SSH remotely, and I had to remove this little mark and enable the setting and change it to yes because it said something else before. Then I think we still need to restart the service for OpenSSH and find out my IP address, and then we're ready to log in remotely, and that's actually on my Windows desktop. So here's my IP address that I can connect to. So this here is my Windows desktop, and I already connected to the server through WinSCP, and that also allows us to open a session in PuTTY like this. But before we start, I strongly advise you to open up this web page also. It's a of course I got it linked in the description below. It's a link to a site that contains the full guide that I'm going to follow step by step in this video, and it should contain all the information you need to get going yourself. Please read through it carefully. It has some additional information that I didn't include in this video. Also, for example, about port mapping. Something which is very important is that you open several ports in your router, and that's also a thing I'm not going into right now. And once you did all that, here we are at step one. We're just going to start right from the start by copy-pasting all these commands in here. Depending on your machine, this goes really fast or not so fast, but I fast forward it anyways. So all the things I was talking about during the recording will be lost. Next step will be installing Nginx plus the RTMP module and certbot so we can request our certificates. Every time you see your domain or your host name or
your mama,
we'll replace it with your own host name or domain name. I already did this beforehand, so I made a little text document, this one. What I did is copied all these in there, and I already edited the lines that I need to edit, that you will also need to edit, but to speed this video up a little bit I did it beforehand, so I'll be copying from this file instead of the website, but yeah, maybe you can do the same, because as you can see you'll need to change something quite often, also in further commands, so maybe it's a tip. Anyways, that's how I'll be getting started now. I'm just going to follow them step by step. So let's just get going. As you can see, this goes rather fast. I don't have to backspace all the time and edit a single thing. I think I'm skipping a step. Hold on. Cloning the GitHub from the RTMP module so we can copy a certain specific file that is in there. You could have also copied it directly from the GitHub, but I chose to do it this way. In case I ever want to recompile Nginx later on, maybe in the future. Oh, I forgot one here. Okay. I prefer to use Joe, but Joe is basically the same as Nano. So anytime you see me use Joe, just replace it with Nano. Copy paste, save the file. I should be using this. Where am I? Copy the cross-domain file, it's this one. I'm going to copy an index file to the root folder of the website that will be temporarily showing, so Let's Encrypt can get validate our certificates. This one. Oops. Going to paste this in. Now remember, like I told you before, you have to edit several lines, also in this this part. And mainly at the top, these ones. I actually commented them like this. So hopefully it will catch your eye. See, I opened my ports. This is the first time it is required that you open port 80 and forward it to the internal MP address of your server. If you're using a server hosted from home, if that is, of course. In other cases, maybe you should open your firewall port 80 and later on also 443 and 1935 UDP if you want to accept streams from the internet. Right, I forgot one specific command earlier. This one, and this contains the package that will create our certificate. So there you go. Now I also included this one, so that's all good. Then we can continue to where we were. Here we go. Enter email address, whatever. All you like, I don't care. I agree. I'm not willing, sorry. Waiting for verification. This looks like it's gone well. There it is, deploying certificate to... So it's gonna make some changes for me in the virtual host file, and I want to choose redirect. That means that all HTTP traffic will be automatically forwarded to HTTPS, and that's it. Those were our certificates. To have a look at the changes that have been done. You can have a look here. Usually at the bottom, these parts have been added by certbot. This part makes sure that port 80 gets forwarded to 443, and this is the part with the certificates. That's all good, that's all good. Our next step will be to get a new nginx.conf. So we're just going to rename this one to nginx-original.conf, just to be sure. And then we can either choose to get a new one with this command. This is on a GitHub page that I quickly created for this purpose, to just hold some configuration files that I'm using in this setup. You can also choose to manually edit the file and just copy paste everything that is in this block right here. We can have a look what's in it. It's quite a lot, as you can see. Now, important thing, down over here are the lines that we'll be using to enable adaptive bitrate streaming. Now, I disabled them for now because first I just want to see if we can get the live streaming server working in its simplest form, so we don't have to go through all sorts of hoops if we want to troubleshoot it. Later on, and maybe I'll make a new video about that, I'll be removing these comments and actually stream it with adaptive bitrate streaming. But for now, we're not, so just so you know. You may want to check through this. I included descriptions of all the options, what they do. Maybe interesting, maybe you want to tweak it, whatever. You're totally free to do so. Okay, so we now should have the server up and running that we can live stream to it, but first we need to restart Nginx first. Okay, that's done. Now I want to show you that streaming is already working at this moment. We're just going to use OBS, which I'm also using to record this actually. Quickly checked out the stream server address, which is the local IP address of your server, dash live, and then use stream as your stream key. And then we can start streaming. This looks like it's working. But just to be sure, you may want to have a look at the stat page that we copied earlier on. Yeah, as you can see, stream's incoming, this is me, and I'm pushing it to an HLS and dash stream, so I can already import it in a video player, but we're not going to at this moment, because we're going to continue with our next step. We have now arrived at step 6, and it's the last step for this part, this video. We're going to download and run video.js to show the HLS live stream that we're... I'm going to start live streaming again, as you can see. I'm live streaming again, so copy this command, but replaced with the correct full name, of course. Okay. Okay, now we have the video.js files. Now we're going to copy this file right here. What I did here is just replace it with the code I already copied earlier, which already contains these correct addresses. You need to change 4 things in this configuration file, and they all have to do with your host name. Let's see. Okay. I forgot something very important. We need to change the width to anything but 0, because else you get a video that has exactly 0 pixels. Okay, let's refresh. This should be showing our stream, as you can see. So that concludes this video, actually. In the next one, we're going to talk about adaptive bitrate streaming and getting that up and running. Maybe I'll be installing PHP and WordPress website on our new server, and use Bradmack's player plugin for WordPress to show our live stream. I hope you liked this video. If it was useful to you, please give me a thumbs up. If it wasn't, please also still give me a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe. Thank you very much for watching. Bye bye.